I'm delirious, man. You're going to get a rant today. I'm on one. Look, first of all, as these chicken nuggets start to digest, the more the shit talk will begin. I slept like shit last night. I slept maybe 5 hours. It was just one of them nights where my brain just kept... And then I woke up. Then I had a little physical therapy appointment. First of all, guys, I've never felt... I'm going to be honest. I've never felt more vanilla than doing a virtual workout session. I'm doing that shit. I'm like, what the fuck? What the fuck is my life? In that, if you would have told me however long ago, like, hey, man, you down to do a virtual workout session? I'd have been like, no. No. I'm not getting on FaceTime with some dude to be like, yeah, do a push-up. Fuck, what am I doing? Now, look, I know it's good for me. It's good for my health. I need it because I'm, like, in pain, and it fixes my pain. But what the fuck? What the fuck? You know, I'm going to be honest. Blueface, he posted a picture of him. The caption is him. Let me show it to you. Blueface doesn't even know what this picture did for me. Let me show you. Let me show you. Hold on. All right. Let me show you what this picture did. Look at Blueface. He's this man barefooted on a stepladder painting his new house. He's doing that home. He's doing that home improvement. Bruh. When I say that this picture made me feel so good about myself. Oh my God. That shit made me feel so good. I was looking at that and I'm like, you know what? It's okay to do a Zoom workout with a physical therapist because Blueface does home improvement with his own two hands. It made me feel so good that Blueface does home improvement. He's an asshole, Jade. Yeah, that might be true, but I needed this. I needed this because it made me feel good that rappers do regular people stuff. You know what I was thinking about? Do rappers wash their dishes? Because I wash my dishes, right? What's wrong? There's nothing wrong, Andy, with DIY. There's nothing wrong. That's why it makes me feel good. How is what related? You want me to relate Blueface doing home improvement to me doing a virtual workout? It means that rappers do regular stuff. You're right. I'm not a rapper. But I'm afraid of becoming vanilla. That's what it is. It's not even... I'll use rappers as like a, you know, rappers for everybody is the metric for not being washed up and on Facebook. And you know that shit is true. You don't even listen to rap. There are some of you in here that don't listen to rap. Shout out my boy, Andrew Barlow. This fool don't listen to rap. Okay. He got all four Beatles tattooed on his fucking back. All right. He got an actual Yellow Submarine as a tramp stamp. But you know this fool is going out in South London on Friday night being like, oh, mate, it's going to be proper lit. Let's get lit, mate. Let's get like, everybody uses rappers as the metric. So my fear is, like, when I listen to rap music, because here's, it's not, when I listen to rap music now and they talk about, like, going to the club, throwing money, just being reckless, I really don't relate to that anymore because I'm the furthest thing from reckless right now. I'm the most put together I've ever been in my entire life. That scares me. I'm so put together. I'm doing physical therapy workouts over Skype, man. 5 years ago, me would have been like, man, fuck that. I'll let this pain. I got some other dumb shit to do. I got priorities to ruin. I got people to ignore. So it scares me that now I'm doing physical therapy workouts over Skype, and I wash my dishes, and I'm taking care of my eczema. You know what I mean? I got this weird feeling. It makes me feel like I need to reactivate my Facebook. I don't even have a Facebook, but it makes me feel like I need to get one again. And I need to, you know, all this shit. And that is weird to me because only up until recently, I've just been reckless my whole fucking life. I've spent so much time fixing all my mistakes, and now I've fixed most of them. And now it's weird. Now I feel like I sold out. I put on rubber gloves and washed the dishes, taking care of my eczema. I'm like, who the fuck am I? I'm weird now. It makes me feel weird, man. I don't want to grow up, man. I don't want to grow up because I did the Benjamin Button. I did it in reverse. I did all that. Bro, I had desk jobs and jobs in general since like 18, man. Don't self-sabotage. This was the goal all along. I know. But it makes you want to do it. You're comparing yourself to rappers that never grew up. That's what I want to be, man. I want to be reckless. A bill collector used to call me to be like, hey, Noel. I'd be like, bitch, shut up. Just do some coke, bro. Who cares? Yeah, I guess, man. Look, dude, it's just, and this is probably because I've been in the house too long. Zero biotic. Yeah, man, I feel that. I had a similar experience. It's pretty crazy. Hang in there. Be happy with the work you get to do. No, I'm definitely happy. Don't get it fucked up. I'm happy. I just worry sometimes if all the shit that I did that made me the person who I was to do the thing I do, now that I do this thing and life is different, and now that I lose sight of that and become washed, and then everyone goes, ah, man, this fool ain't even.
No, I feel this so hard. I feel like I blew past my reckless years so fast, and now I'm like, I want to do something crazy and reckless and act like I'm in a coming-of-age movie. Also, happy 3 months.
Thank you, man. Appreciate that.
Are you sure you're not getting antsy and desiring impulsiveness because we're locked down? Maybe you need to take a break after we're free and do a bunch of shit off the list.
Yeah, probably.
I'm off the edible, and your rant got me thinking about life and shit.
Hey, man, that was me last night. I got a little fade. Oh, I'm gonna get fucked up tonight. I'm gonna be real. I'm gonna get so fucked up tonight. Normal. Bro, we're all.
Self-care doesn't make you vanilla. Take care of yourself, King. We love you.
We all shitty here. We're all shitty here. You know why we're all shitty? You know why we're all shitty? Because you've all done this. You've all done this at some point in your life. The phone is ringing, and it's somebody who needs something. And every single one of you have done this. Yeah, it's old crybaby bitch calling me right now. Yeah, he gonna have to call me later. I'ma just fucking... Hey, pass me that eyeliner, bitch. We going out tonight. You've all done it. My dad had cancer. You know, one day I'm like, Dad, can you just be cool just today? It's all about you. I want to have a day. Oh, shit. Am I being for real? Yeah. That's like some shit I talk about when I was working on my new stand-up set. I talk about that. I've talked about that on stream before. Dad, like, I need chemo. I'm like, Dad, I need money. Some of us are good people and answer the phone. Yeah, Abby, you answer the phone. But then what you hear, okay, all right, back to hell. For everyone that answers the phone and goes, oh my God, what do you need? Here's where you're a bad person. Here's where the bad person in you comes out. Then you go tell a friend that you took the call and you start doing this. Oh, and they needed help, and I sat there and I listened and I just talked him through it. And me, the listener, felt so bad for them. And I just was there for them in their time of need. And I've just, you know, I really have a way of looking after people. Because, you know, that's what my mom taught me to do, was to look after people and to just be so caring about everyone that's not me. I just know how to separate myself from myself because I'm just so good at caring. Good for you. Oh, you care? Good for
Someone
you.
Someone could be dying and I still ain't gonna answer no phone. Are you kidding me?
How are you not laughing while doing this? I'm dead inside, bitch. Am I good?
Happy
no, I'm not
too.
Good.
I've been going through it lately and this stream has really helped. Keep doing what you're doing.
Of course. Hey, you know some... You know something that clicked with me? Okay. You think back, like, and this is some old shit to say. I don't fucking care. Think back, like, 20 years ago. I know you wasn't born 20 years ago. Meh, 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 meh. I don't care about that. I don't care about that. 20 years ago, right? 25 years ago, affection was like, oh, take me on a date. Oh, let's do something nice. Take me on a dinner. Pay it, you know. I did this thing because I know you got this interest and I got you this thing. Now, affection is this. Babe, react to me naked for TikTok. Do it. Do the thing that everyone else does that looks like affection. Do it for me. Do it for me. Give me the affection that I have seen online. Give it to me.
Thanks for everything.
I'm recording you. It's like dating the fucking police, man. All my friends got the affection. I want it now, too. Like.
Babe, would you date me if I was a worm?
Yeah. Say you would fuck me if I was a worm. Say it. Internet got everybody fucked up. People don't even know what they like or who they are. They never step away. Chili said that's because people don't know the difference between attention and affection. And I'm not trying to overanalyze or find some shit that's deep and it's not what I'm saying. But it does freak me out when I see those TikToks, like, if people, like, I did this to my boyfriend, and then all these other people, like, start replicating it. Like, I know it starts as fun and all that shit, but I feel like with that and, like, posting pictures of your significant other and everything you do and your anniversaries and your fucking mom, it's like you're wearing a body cam for your whole life. And it's like, not, it just, this goes back to shit I've said before. The oversharing is wild. Like, motherfuckers might as well just get a GoPro, put that shit on their chest, and start logging everything they do. Listen, I'll tell you this right now. Here's a laugh for you. If you gotta put your man on camera to get a good reaction out of him, he don't love you. If you gotta put them on camera to get a good reaction, they don't love you. They don't love you. Tell me that you like my naked body. Tell me that you like it. Tell me that you like it right now. Noel with the nuanced takes once again. What can I say, man? What can I say? I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, dude. I'm a fucking idiot. That's what I feel every day. I say all this dumb shit comes out of my head, but I don't see real people laughing at it. I just see, like, text. This shit could all be fake. This could be 4,000 Russian bots controlled by one guy. None of this shit could be real. What did I just walk into? Nothing, Amanda, because you haven't walked anywhere. You're sitting in your room and you ain't left that bitch in 30 days.
Don't make me come there and prove him real, Bruv.
If you just joined into the stream, welcome. I'm ranting my fucking ass off. I'm just talking this shit. I've lost my mind. Guys, do you realize what the fuck? I've done it all in the past 5 weeks on stream. It feels ridiculous. Racing cars, Ian Sterling, Call of Duty, you know, killing motherfuckers with a steering wheel, a beach party with Spock. He took that idea and ran with it and created all these parties. I've lost it. We cooked with these game nights. I've lost it. I've lost it. I'm out of my fucking mind, man. How to get back to this? How to get back to this and just talking shit? It's just fucking, oof. It's fucking, I need to. Hey, this is some random shit to say, but I was laughing because I gotta be straight with you. When I hear these new rappers, let's take the Kid Laroi, for example. Let's take this song, right?
Please take a break, my guy. You deserve
okay.
It.
Thank
I love you.
I need a bad bitch. All right. This song. I never could have related to this at 18 or 17 or 19 or 21 or 20. I could have never. At 18, I was working bullshit ass jobs, moving boxes. I was mad as fuck at this age. And you know, when I hear like all these people make these songs that sound like they're trying to clone like Cardi and Uzi and Thug, and it's all this fake like happy shit, I'm like, I don't get this shit. I don't get this music. Never at 18 was I feeling any. Never in my life. I never felt this shit in my life. I was mad as fuck. Moving boxes. Mad as hell. Moving boxes. Getting curved. I was lacking game because I was so angry. It'd be a fucking kid on his parents' money. With some chick I might have tried to say something to, and they just. I need a bad bitch. I'd be mad at my shitty job. Like, man, fuck them both. Fuck them both. This is why you like the struggle rap from the 90s. But I said, Joe, what are you talking about, struggle rap? I mean, I wouldn't call it struggle. I like rappers that had to overcome some shit. That's the funniest shit to me about TikTok, bro, is like, imagine you're like, you're a dude from like Florida or the South. Or even now, like North Carolina or whatever. Just somewhere where the sound is different. Might be the culture might be more welcoming to like melodic shit. Imagine you overcome some deep socioeconomic hardship by way of rap music, and then you gotta your music is just consumed by girls named Savannah pumping their fists on TikTok. Just got it. Fucking slat. That shit gotta feel bad, bro. Yo, and then they want to turn around and get on Twitter and be like, rappers need to stop rapping about shooting and guns and drugs. That music is not for you.
I hate that TikTok is like, it's ruining everything. Everyone just makes their shit to pop off there. And
I promise that I didn't mean it like that.
No, no, I got you. I got you.
Struggles, you know?
Yeah, yeah, no, Jody.
You
all
really
you.
Change the definition of struggle with your girl defined video. Raps about real stuff.
Yeah, no, I feel it.
I feel it. Rappers need to start rapping about Whole Foods and Starbucks, and that'll fix it. No, bro, Larry June. Larry June raps about like being healthy and being responsible. And motherfuckers give him shit, and they call him boring. It's fucking dumb. TikTok fucking shit up, man. Everybody's a consumer. Everything is propaganda, bro. Everybody trying to sell something. That's kind of why I like doing these streams where it's not like some fucking big event and it's all marketed and it's like, then it's going to be, it's just like, just let, some shit just needs to, and some shit just needs to be okay. Like, fuck, man, this sounds like some real boomer talk, sir. I can't help it, dog. This is the job I have, and that shit is just like beaming me between the fucking eyes. I don't like, bro, I don't, I have a certain degree of like self-judgment, and wherever it comes from, it doesn't fucking matter, but it's like, I have a certain degree of like, you know, voice in my head that's like, you gotta be better, or you gotta be a certain way, like, what? And so I just have a hard time like doing shit and just like puking it out. I can't even consume some of this shit because it just makes me feel like,
if I'm on your life in modern day Jerry Seinfeld with your hatred of modern culture.
Thanks, Colton, man. That's a big compliment. I don't think I'm anything like, I'm not to the degree of Seinfeld, bro, but I appreciate that. Dog, you know what's weird to me? Is the whole like, I remember talking about this with this dude I used to work with, and you know, we were talking about in the scope of time, the concept of like wanting to be famous. That's super new. Even like 100 fucking years ago, it's not to the degree that it is now. And now I don't know. I feel like now everyone tries to do shit so fast and so young because they want to pretend. They want to have that pseudo superstardom. I know I just, in so many ways, I said clout chasing. Watch me run these people out the stream. Like, they're like, what the fuck? I just want to be like, fuck, what is this? You're new here. Get with it. Well, I'm not trying to make shit serious or whatever, but I am. I am trying to make it serious because, dude, at least for me, you know, I liked it when people gave a fuck because I found it hard to give a fuck. So I guess now, like, I give a fuck about things. And so, you know, if there's anyone there that feels like no one gives a fuck, I think that's my problem, is no one gives a fuck anymore. Like, the concept of art, what the fuck? You rarely see good art anymore. That's what music is supposed to be. That's what comedy was supposed to be. That's what all the good shit, you know, cinema, all that. It's rarely art anymore. It's just some guy or a team of this, and they got the money to do that, and they just trying to fucking just ram that shit down your fucking throat. They just trying to make you buy it, stream it, sell it, swipe it, bro. I feel like everything, I can't say everything, but so much shit lacks fucking personality. And you got so many stupid people that are like the metric for like success and shit. I don't know, man. So what I was saying was, you feel like a psycho because you see something, you're like, this is good, and then you try to like tell someone, you try to tell like an acquaintance, or you know, you try to share that, you'd be like, hey, look at this fucking dope piece of art, and then that person is like, this fucking bleh. And they want more of that, like, trash. It's just, like, their appetite for shit is just so bad. It's just fucking, what? What? And just speaking for myself, I feel this weird pressure to cut corners or to, like, sacrifice shit. Because now that I'm, like, at a certain point, I feel this weird thing where I'm, like,
oh, but, you know, I got to care about the fucking algorithm. Which, I'll be real, that's kind of why, like, you know, like with sketches and the way I'm doing it, like Steamy Tweets, Love Island, that stuff, it grew my channel and it put a lot of eyeballs on what I'm doing, and I appreciate that. But you guys know, like, my bread and butter. AK again, hell yeah.
I graduate college in 3 weeks. I went for acting. It's what I want to do with my life, but there is so much pressure to be on every social media and have a following just to get a job.
Yeah.
Like, I just want to act. I want to be hired on my merit, not clout.
Bear, I'm going to be real with you. If you want to take that road with acting, that's the route you want to go, you're in for a tough road. Because getting by on just your skill, it ain't like that anymore. It's wild, too, because in Hollywood and everywhere else, they want you to be fucking famous on the internet, but then they'll turn right around and be like, the internet doesn't matter. Fucking. Oh, man. Die9, I get it. This is not like a problem that's exclusive to me, but where I was going with that is just like, I'm kind of taking like a hard stance on like, bro, I'm the like capacity in my brain is not just fucking playing a little mobile game on the internet. Like, I got way more shit to offer than that. And it fucking makes me feel bad sometimes. I mean, I push it out of my head now, but it's like I put up that sketch vid and just like low key insulting a little bit. Like, some people go, this isn't Love Island. I'm like, then fucking unsubscribe, bro. Like, I put hard work into this shit, and you're just going to sit there with the fucking drool coming out of your face. Like, I just want to see love. Like, what? Fuck off, man. It's not that there's anything wrong with that video, but it's like, it's this shitty thing where people go, yeah, but it's not what I wanted. All right, bitch, go have another 16th birthday. Tell your dad you didn't like your last birthday and you want another one because he doesn't love you. You need him
just
to buy.
Just find the art that you care about and be passionate about it.
Yes, sir.
You can find people equally enthusiastic about it if you look.
No, I know. I know you guys fucking care. You guys are into it. That's all that matters to me. But you have to understand, bro, it's hard. Like, when you're living off your fucking art,
that's
it's hard
to. How I
feel
about movies. So many of them are just Hollywood trash now. And I just want to make good movies, but how can you even do that without buying into Hollywood garbage?
It's tough, man. Bro, you know that moment, like, when you're watching, like, a good piece of, like a good TV show, and you could tell where the studio stepped in, and they're like, you need to explain this part.
It's so fucking hard to be a creative, and so many of my friends and family clown me for wanting to go into cinematography, with one of my friends saying it's pretentious and no one watches shit BC is pretty anymore anyway, and it's trash.
Whoa. Kat said, it's getting so weird, I'm like, what's with life anymore? That's the fuck I go through every day.
Keep the change, you filthy animal.
Love you, King. We are all in emo hours.
Thank you.
Thank you for streaming on Mother's Day.
No problem.
Today is hard for me because my mom and I have never been close. I really hope you feel better soon, King.
I feel you on that. It's all right. We'll fill the void with TikTok. No, thanks for tuning in. Yeah, bro, if you want to go into cinematography, don't for a second let people who don't understand cinematography tell you that cinematography doesn't matter. Because that's the funniest shit. That's the funniest shit, too. If someone who says cinematography doesn't matter will care. Because they'll watch a movie and they don't. They'll walk out of a movie and go, that was really good. But they don't even understand what the fuck they liked about it. Their brain just knows, like, that was really good. And when a movie's bad, they know it's bad. They just don't know how to describe a bad movie or what makes it bad. Those are the people that are the first to complain when something isn't good. It's so funny. It's so funny. Anyway, let me relax. Let me woosah. All right, let me. This is honestly why I tune in. Thanks for this kind of stream.
Why I tune in. Thanks for this kind of stream.
Bear, yeah, I know it'll be hard. My school focused on telling us about the industry and just not the technique, so I know what I'm stepping into. It just sucks. Imagine being told by your professors to make TikToks and tweets. Oh, yeah, bro. That shit is trash. That shit is so trash, bro.
The way things are sucks, but it's okay to be angry and shows that you care. Apathy feeds the machine.
Yes, it does, sir. Yes, it does.
Everything is propaganda. Everything is propaganda.
Buy some shit. Buy some shit. Hey, did you finally get a paycheck? Thank God, because we have something that you can buy. Oh. The last thing I'm going to say on this rant is I get in these weird headspaces where I do some shit, like on the internet, and I'm like, am I even like me? Do I even like what the fuck I just did right there? Am I like, am I being true to myself? It's fucking, it makes you want to fucking puke, man. It's weird. It's fucking weird. Anyway, I should listen to Art Is Dead by Bo Burnham. Yeah, I should check that out. Probably make me feel better. I like this.
Not off. Be questioning life.
Pump He's it. Questioning life. Pump it.
To be honest with you, I would rather see you do one sketch video than 10 more Love Island videos, especially if you feel like it's your best work and the most you have to offer, and I know I'm not the only one who thinks that.
Yeah,
thanks
bro.
Thanks for what you do, man.
I appreciate that.